Hello, Airbus cockpit coach here. You're joining me in the flight deck of the inibuilds A350, and in this video we're going to look at the descent. I've currently got the simulator paused just before our top of descent into John F. Kennedy. As we're about 10 miles out from our top of descent, which is indicated by the white down tick there on the navigation display on our path. So that's the ideal optimum place for us to begin our descent down to our arrival aerodrome. There's a few things we want to consider before we begin our descent, and first of all we want to look at our EFIS, make sure it's displaying the correct data that we want to see for our descent. So if we're flying into weather beneath us, we want the weather radar on. If terrain is going to be a factor, we definitely want the terrain on, either the first officer's side or the captain's side. We may split those out, so consider what the big factors are for your flight and display that relevant information. So make sure you display the information that's going to help you most from a safety perspective. Next, you want to consider use of seat belts. Depending on your company's standard operating procedures, you may want to turn these on as you begin the descent. For operators, turn these on at different stages, just before 10,000 feet even, but in any case, turn them on if there's turbulence. Next we come down and we look at TCAS, and we want to put that into below so we've got a deeper picture of the traffic beneath us as we descend. We also want to consider bringing up the appropriate charts on our OIS screen here. And here we've got the arrival into New York for tonight's flight. So we can constantly cross-check that and ensure that matches our restrictions as we come down and ensure that we're meeting those. So it's improving our situational awareness. So air traffic control may give us an instruction to descend when ready to an altitude. They may descend us early, or they may actually descend us late, so which is not ideal. Descend when ready, obviously we would get the aircraft going down on our profile. We want to consider selecting the low altitude just before our top of descent marker, usually about 3 miles out, so it takes a little bit of time for the engines to spool back and the attitude of the aircraft to start lowering, so it can intercept that path properly. So bear that in mind. If we are cleared to descend early and we select a low altitude in and we go into a managed descent, the aircraft will descend at a rate of 1,000 feet per minute until it reaches the profile, and then it will increase or decrease to maintain the profile. If we overshoot our top of descent, there are a few things we can do to recover that. We could go into an open descent mode, so we select down on the altitude selector and increase our speed. In open descent, the aircraft tracks the speed side, and in managed descent, if we select up on the altitude selector, it will target the profile, but it has a limited speed range. In open descent as well, we could also deploy our spoilers to help increase our rate of descent while keeping speed under control. However, that's not optimum from a efficiency point of view, so we want to avoid that if possible. So let's unpause the sim and we'll look at that. So let's say now we're cleared to flight level 200 by air traffic control, and that's a descent now, so it's an early descent. We go up into descent. The aircraft will now track down and will start descending at 1,000 feet per minute until it picks up our profile. Now you see here on the primary flight display, this green ball here on the right side indicates the profile, so we're now going below profile because we descended early. As we get closer to the profile, the ball will come down and we'll intercept that, and in this managed descent mode the aircraft will track the ball. On the left here you see we've got some magenta markers opened. The triangle here in the middle is our target speed, but the aircraft has the option of flying above the target speed to help it maintain the profile, or below it to help it maintain the profile as well. So it has a bit of flex to adjust speed to help the aircraft stay in profile. If we were to select down and go into open descent, the thrust idle open descent here, the aircraft will disregard the profile and will fly with regards to the selected speed. So we don't have to do that now. So we'll go back into descent. Mach descent. And you see now we're coming over the profile. And the aircraft will pick up that profile, so vertical speed is now increasing downwards. Thrust idle. Thrust descent. Now, thrust descent is something a little bit different. You won't see that in the Airbus A320, for example. So the A350 does keep a little bit of thrust in to avoid thermal shock and prolong the life of the engines in descent. So we're tracking down our profile nicely. So always remember with air traffic control, if you haven't yet had your clearance to descend, you want to request that in advance so you don't end up high on profile. We also want to consider use of anti-ice in descent. We have nice clear conditions today. However, if we are descending and there's cloud around, whenever the TAT temperature down here is below plus 10 degrees and you are in visible moisture, you want to be putting engine anti-ice on up here. But we don't need that today. We disregard the SAT temperature in descent, which is different to the ascent climb. But if we do get visible icing on the airframe, so you see it on the probes or around the windshield, you would turn on your wing anti-ice. So wing anti-ice, we react when we have visible presence of ice on the aircraft. So we continue to monitor our descent, making sure we stay on profile and meet restrictions. And you see the descent page on the performance page has now opened up. You can see our vertical deviation from our profile here on the bottom right. And you can also use the predictive function to tighten your altitudes in to see when you'll be at that altitude. So we're being cleared now to flight level 200. We'll be there in 30 nautical miles at 1850. So a useful feature there. Around about your top of descent is also a good time to give a call to the cabin crew just to let them know you are beginning the descent. That indicates to them to expect landing in around 30 minutes time. And they can prepare the cabin accordingly. So if we leveled off here, we'll end up obviously high on profile. You see that deviation increasing down here. It will get to a point where in managed descent mode, the aircraft will not have enough flex in terms of speed to recapture the profile. Get back into managed descent now. Thrust descent, descent. Approaching 2,500 feet above profile now. Thrust idle. So it's descending at a faster rate and the aircraft's going to start increasing speed. Try and recapture the profile. So we've got a very heavy descent rate here. So we are regaining that, and the blue arrow there on the navigation display is when we expect to regain our profile or level out, essentially, at flight level 200. We're going to the top of the speed gate here, so that's the maximum the maximum speed the aircraft can now go in descent, so it's going to be about 3,000 feet per minute. It is catching it up, so if it wasn't able to, we could go and select open descent, which will target the speed. Again, you could increase speed in descent, so you can open the speed window, increase your speed here to give you a better rate of descent, and if really necessary you can deploy the speed brakes. That should be a last resort because it's inefficient and it's not great energy management of the aircraft. Speed up starts approaching 200. I'll put it back into managed descent now and put its speed back. If you are on a heading, you won't be able to fly in managed descent. So it'll be an open descent if you're on heading. So you have to be in nav mode for managed descent to work. As soon as you come out of onto heading mode, you'll need to be in open descent. Obviously vertical speed is an option, but there's some dangers with vertical speed where the aircraft can overspeed. As pilots, we refer to this as a very silly mode, so VS mode, because it has some dangers around it. So I'm going to keep descent down to 9,000 feet now. So once you select an altitude that's below the transition level, so we're going into a US airport here, transition level is 18,000. We can pull for local pressure on the Q&H and also run the approach checklist. That can be done at this stage, or it can be done depending on airline SOP. Some of them are below 10,000 feet. We've done our briefing. ECAM status is normal. We can now turn on the seat belts for our approach. Again, that's kind of at our discretion. We've set our minimums and our RRF set and cross-checked three times. Approach flight level 100. Generally in the US, below 18,000 feet, you'll have the landing lights on. And they like the wing lights on over here as well, so that's an option you can put on. So now below 10,000, we want to ensure our landing system's on both sides. Seat belts are on, we've got our landing lights on, and again, we've got the EFIS correctly configured for our landing. So you may want to consider bringing the range down now. Meeting our restriction of 9,000 feet at Rover. And we could, so we're on a track here and we'd expect a vector normally for the approach. So we may now want to put in an extended runway center line as we're going to expect to be vectored off for our approach. Anticipating an early turn, I'm going to put the aircraft now into open descent. And start coming back on the speed. 220 knots for now. Obviously we may have ATC speed restrictions. And to extend a center line out, we want to select our waypoints on our final approach track through the direct to page. So go direct to, select, we can use meals there. Inbound course, so we want to go course in. It's got the correct course there, so we go direct to insert. And then we have our extended runway center line in. So we can now, we've come out of nav mode, gone into heading mode. We can say we've been cleared under heading of 255 via ATC. We want to push down on heading mode again, otherwise the aircraft, this mode for example, it's going to intercept the final approach track and we may not be cleared for that, so select heading again. And we'll continue our descent down now to 3,000 feet. The blinds put away, so we've got good visibility around us for the approach. Very slightly above profile here. Because we've got a speed restriction, if we'd be simulating a speed restriction here of 220 knots, one way to get down would be to use the speed brake in this scenario. So the pitch of the nose can drop further without the speed of the aircraft increasing. I've just deployed them and you see the vertical speed. It's increasing that. There's our profile coming back in. And once we're back on profile, we can take the speed brake back in. Now a change to our approach plate. So we want the 3-1 left localizer. Tap that up for reference. Now we are coming in on our intercept angle to the localizer. We're leveling out now at 3,000 feet. Air traffic control has now cleared us for the ILS approach. So we can select approach and autopilot 1 and 2. Confirm our FMAs. So we're land free, dual, autopilot 1 and 2 is confirmed. And you'll see we've got glyphosate and localizer armed in blue. I'm going to come to the perf page and activate the approach. And if we've lost our speed restriction, we can now select manage speed. At this stage, it will decrease speed back to green dot speed. Cabin's ready, that's flashing there. And we can also bring out the first stage of flaps. We can go flaps 1, speed checks flaps 1. And the speed will now drop back to the S speed. Lockstar, so we're now turning inbound on the ILS. Confirming our localizer, India Mike Oscar Hotel, 111.35. Inbound course is correct. Bring our range down. And that's the descent to approach in the Airbus A350. If you have any questions on that, please drop them in the comments. And don't forget to hit like and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest content. Thanks for watching.